Girl, you should wear a name tag.
Ni vicious presenting.
Hey guys, so this is going to be a haul video, actually a try-on haul, and it's the stuff that I bought in Barcelona when I was there a few weeks ago. I've actually kept the things in the bags just so that I won't forget and that I would do this video. And also I'm going to show you stuff that I bought here in Sweden too, after I came home. So it's kind of a collective haul. So let's just jump right into the bags and just pick up random stuff and I'll tell you where I bought it and show you how it looks on. So the things that are at the top are actually things that I bought in Sweden. So first off, I have three t-shirts that I bought. This is the first one. So it's just a plain, like, ordinary loose t-shirt. And it's from Gina Tricot, a store here in Sweden. And this is actually made by organic cotton, so it's super soft and also better for the environment. And then I also bought the same ones, but in two other colors. So here is the first one. It's kind of a burgundy type of wine red color. It's the same thing. It's the same organic cotton and everything, just another color. And I feel like this color is perfect now for the fall time. The reason why I bought these t-shirts is because this summer I noticed I only have tight stuff. So I love wearing tight clothes, but sometimes you feel bloated or hot or something and you just don't want to wear tight stuff. And then I had nothing to wear when I had those days. So now I just went crazy and bought a bunch of loose t-shirts so that I have comfy clothes to just walk around in and throw on with a pair of jeans and like a leather jacket or something when I don't feel like wearing tight clothes. And the third t-shirt with the same model is in this color. It's kind of a mustard yellow color, and I really like it. I haven't had a lot of yellow clothes before, but I bought a yellow bodysuit a while ago, and I fell in love with yellow, so now I wanted to buy a more fall yellow colored thing to wear this, yeah, fall and winter. So I really like this one. And then also in Sweden, after I came home, I bought this bodysuit, and it's from Bikbok, and it looks like this. It's a black bodysuit that's really v-necked. Oh, hair on my arm. It's a black bodysuit that goes really low in the front and has like these details, and it's also pretty open in the back, so it's quite revealing, but I really, really like this bodysuit. I feel like you can wear it with a blazer over top and not be so naked, but also you can wear it with like flowy pants like I will show you in the video, or a skirt or something, like whatever you feel like. I really love having these types of bodysuits because I feel like it's a safe bet. Like when you don't know what to wear when going out, I always go for a bodysuit. And I forgot to mention the t-shirts were 99 Swedish crowns and the bodysuit was around 200 Swedish crowns. Next up we have the flowy pants that I mentioned before when I talked about the bodysuit, and I have been in love with comfortable, but nice pants that just look good but are comfortable as pajama pants. So I have bought a lot lately, but these ones I bought in Barcelona and they are like a khaki green color. They are from Pimki. I have seen this brand in Serbia before. Don't know if I have seen it in Sweden, but it's spelled P-I-M-K-I-E. So Pimki. And they are just super duper flowy at the bottom and have a nice, like, more dressed up material, so I feel like you can wear it with heels and be chic and good looking for a night out, or you can dress them down and actually wear them even during the day with flat shoes. They were around, I think, 20 euros, but I also think that I got them for a discounted price, so I don't remember exactly, but around 20 euros, maybe a little bit less. Then I bought this lovely knitted thing. It's a shorter, like, knitted top, and it has these awesome details on the arms. So it's kind of like a corset type thing on the arms, and it's just long sleeved, and I thought it would be awesome now for fall and winter. And it was 19.99 euros, and it's from Bershka. I think that's how you call say that store. I like that it isn't all plain, so you feel a little bit more fun when you wear it. And here we have another t-shirt, because as I said, I wanted to buy a lot of t-shirts just to have something that isn't tight when I feel like wearing something loose. So this is also from Bershka, and it just says Party? Yes, you maybe. So it's a little bit cocky and it's light pink. I usually don't wear pinks a lot, but light pink is easier for me to like feel comfortable in. I like these type of t-shirts with prints because I feel like you can easily wear them with like a blazer during the day at work or something and look not too dressed up but still, you know, comfortable but chic at the same time. But you can also just wear them with jeans and be super casual. So I really like that. And this I also bought in Barcelona and it's just nipple covers. I don't know how to pronounce this store, but I think you say Oysho, and it's always super useful to have these. For example, for that bodysuit that I showed you before where you can't wear a bra because it's too V-necked and has an open back. And these were 7.99 euros. And then in a makeup store, I don't remember what it was called, I bought two of the L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara that's super hyped, and it looks a little bit different in Spain, but it's the same thing, essentially. So I bought two of them just because it hadn't came out in Sweden when I bought it, and now it has, and I will be uploading a first impressions review on this one, so if you are curious to know my thoughts on it, you can wait for that one. And I also bought an eyeliner pencil that, like a Kohl pen, that I'm regretting not buying more because I love it so much. So this is from Bourjois, and it's the Contour Clubbing Waterproof Eye Pencil. It's an orange metallic type color because I thought it is a great color both for summer and for fall and winter. So it's super good actually. I just usually use it smudged on the lower lash line just to get a pop of color, but not being too much, you know. So I do kind of a neutral look like I have right now, and I just put it and smudge it on my lower lash line, and then it is actually super waterproof and holds up, and I don't have to set it with any powder or stuff like that. And then when we were going home, of course I had to stop in the tax-free store at the airport, and I repurchased my favorite mascara actually for a few years now, and it's the Lancôme Hypnose Doll Eyes in Waterproof. I really, really like this mascara, so this is like the 8th time or 10th time or something I repurchased this, so I just had to when it was cheaper in the tax-free store, of course. And then I did something big. I bought a new perfume. That's also big. But yeah, I rarely buy new perfumes because I'm really picky with perfumes. I hate everything that smells like flowers, and there's a lot of perfumes that smell like flowers. I like sweet perfumes, but not obnoxiously sweet, so it's always hard to find a balance and something that doesn't smell like flowers. But my choice fell on this one, and it's from Victor and Rolf, and it's their Bomb Bomb perfume. I can insert a picture of what it looks like open because it's really cute, like a purpley bow. And I bought the big one that is 90 milliliters, and that is 3.04 fluid ounces. I thought it was worth buying the big bottle because in the end you save up a bit of money because the smaller bottle is also really expensive. For the amount you get, it's less than if you bought two of the small ones or whatever. This one was actually pretty expensive even though it was in the tax-free. It was 117 euros. So it's a lot, but as I said, it would be more expensive if I bought it somewhere else or if I bought the smaller one and then had to buy a small one again. So I think it would be worth it because I really, really like the smell of this one. So then when I was back in Sweden, I couldn't stop buying makeup as usual. So I have some new stuff that I bought here too. And this is a repurchase that I've bought a lot of times, and it's actually a skincare product from Naturpharm. And I buy it from a Danish site, actually. It's called MED24 something. I can link it down below. But it's their Caviar Anti-Age Eye Serum. It really tightens the under eye area. So if I feel puffy or tired or something, I always grab this one and curl my lashes, and I feel much better. And I love nail polish, and I can't be without nail polish. So I bought two new colors from Essie. I mean, they're not new for Essie, but they're new to me. So it's the Wild Nude that looks like this, and it's actually the one I'm wearing on my nails right now. And then I bought a typical fall winter color, and it's the Bordeaux color, also from Essie. And they are around 129 Swedish crowns at Kicks. And then I have quite an embarrassing purchase to tell you about, guys. I usually don't fall for the hype, like I hate when stuff get hyped up, so that's why I've been putting off this purchase for so long. But I mean, I fell for all the good reviews, and I also had a 20% off coupon at Kicks, so I bought the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance Palette. Did you think I was going to say the subculture palette? Uh-uh. Not trying that one. Maybe I'm the last person on earth to buy this palette, but I actually saw it for the first time a few weeks ago when I bought this in real life. And then when I got to see the colors in real life and like touching the palette and also reading more and more good reviews on it, I had to buy it when I had 20% off. Why not? So the packaging is really nice, but I do know it will get super dirty, and that's the negative thing about this soft touch packaging. But it is really pretty to look at. It's just, I know it's going to get dirty and messy, and I don't like dirty and messy. I think all of you know what this looks like, and I'm the last one jumping on this boat, I was about to say. But if you don't know, this is what the palette looks like, and I really think I'm going to like it. Like, now when I've seen the colors in real life, I really think I'm going to like it. But if you want me to do a first impressions review on this one, please let me know and I will hook you up. This is about 550 Swedish crowns at Kix, but as I said, I had a 20% off coupon, so I got it for a little bit less. That's everything for this huge haul, and I hope it hasn't been boring and that you like the stuff I bought. And if you have any requests, please comment down below on what videos I should do. And if you like this one, please don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. But until my next video, have an awesome day or night or morning or whenever you're watching this. Bye! That's a wrap, everybody!
Take 300! 'Cause I need you on the dance floor. 4 a.m. and we go home. I guess it's this thing now, eh?